Today we're going to talk about the power of leaving a profit. Yes, I said it. The power of leaving a profit. When I speak about leaving a profit, I'm not talking necessarily about leaving a financial profit. I'm speaking about leaving value. Have you ever gone into a rental space where you rented out to someone and they just moved out and the place was completely trashed? Have you gone into a dorm room and a dorm resident just left? And as they just left, they left the place completely trashed. Have you ever gone to church or gone to a function or gone to a office space where people used it for a meal or used it for something on occasion and they leave it totally trashed? Have you ever gone into your children's room or your room or the kitchen and someone had used the kitchen and they left it completely trashed? That's what we're going to talk about today in terms of leaving a profit. When we leave a profit, is that we leave something of value behind. You see, whenever you leave an apartment or whenever you rented an apartment from someone, you keep it clean. You keep it upkeep. You keep the carpets vacuumed. And if you spill something on the carpet, you clean it up. You clean the kitchen regularly. You clean the bathrooms regularly. So when you leave it pristine. When you leave it in better condition than you met it. That's what we're going to be talking about today. Leaving a profit. When you get up, you make your room. And when you make your room, you put away your toys. You put away your clothes. You put away your shoes. You put away your makeup. You put away all of the things where they need to go. So you leave a profit. You leave that room clean. You leave that room in good shape. When you use the kitchen, you wash the dishes. You put them away. You put away used bag boxes of cereal. You wrap it up, close it up, seal it up, and put it where it needs to go. You do not put a half-filled bottle of soda back into the fridge. You use it and then you discard of the bottle. If the milk carton is empty, then you add it to the shopping list. You see, you leave a profit. You leave value. You see, even in our relationships, we have a tendency of sucking. We sit down with our friends and we want their attention. We want, but we never give anything. Whenever we are around people, we'll need to approach them with the notion that you're going to deposit something in them. You're going to give them a word of encouragement. You're going to pour something in them. So when you leave them, you leave them with a profit. Whenever somebody sows into your life, then you reciprocate that. Whenever somebody speaks life into your life, then you bless them back. Whenever somebody does something for you, you show some degree of appreciation. You leave a profit. Whenever you go and you buy a car, you don't expect the guy to sell you the car below the sticker price and then knock off all of his profit. And you walk away and you say, wow, I got such an awesome deal. I got it for little or nothing, because then he doesn't make a commission. And if he doesn't make a commission, he can't pay his bills. He can't support his family. So how does that make you feel? You see, whenever we leave a profit, it creates a win-win situation in which both parties win, in which both parties feels like they are appreciated. And that's what you want to do. When you go and you use a room and you use an area for a function, for a party or anything, you clean it up, you mop the floor, you dump away the trash, you put the chairs back, you do all what you need to do to leave a profit. Always leave a profit. When somebody lends you something, you take it. You use it, you clean it, and you take it back in a timely manner. You always leave a profit. Do not take it back dirty, and do not take it back late, and do not let them have to call you and say, didn't I not lend you something 2 weeks ago? Can I have it back? Don't let them have to call you. Always leave a profit. Whenever you sit around with people and you're going to visit with your friends, think about some way you could encourage them. Think about some way you could speak life into them. Don't be the one who attaches and then runs along with the bandwagon. You know, they're down, so woe is me. You sit down there and you say how bad the other person was, and you know, you're all right and they are wrong. And you, no. You leave a prophet. You encourage them. You pour life into them. And by pouring life into them, you build them up. We have to learn to build each other up. We have to learn in every single situation that we leave a prophet. We're in such a society where we just figure it's all about us. It's about me. I'm here. You need to pay me attention. You need to give me service. You need to bring me my stuff when I want it. You see, I need to leave things higgly piggly. It's your job to clean it up. It's the waiter's job to pick up what's on the floor. It's the waiter's job to pick up what's I spilled all over the table. It's the waiter's job to do this. It's the cleaner or the janitor's job to clean up after me. So if I drop droppings all over the floor, or I put paper towels all over the place, then they'll come and pick it up because that's their job. It's not my job. We have to learn to leave a prophet. We have to leave a prophet in our relationships. We have to leave our prophet in our organizations. We have to leave prophets in every single situation. When you go to the store and you drop something and you break something, let them know and pay for it. You see, you dropped it. You know, you broke it. You know, whenever you do something or whenever you are involved in something, always learn to leave a prophet. Always tell people, you can never be around me for 5 minutes or even a minute and not learn something. If you come around me, bring your pen and your paper because you're going to learn something. If you walk away and you didn't learn something, it's not my fault. It's your fault because you weren't listening. If you listen to me speaking at any given time when I speak to someone, I will always drop little gold nuggets. I will always drop a little bit of wisdom. I will always pour wisdom. You could ask me any question you could ask or learn something when you're around me, and I will answer. So if you didn't learn something, it's because you didn't ask. You see, that's what the problem is with a lot of times, is that when we come into situation thinking, okay, we're here to relax. You know, we just don't want to think about nothing. We just want to just relax. No, you should always be learning, especially when you're around people who are very versed at things, or if you're around people who know a lot of things, you should come prepared to deposit something into their lives by sharing some words of wisdom, sharing some words of encouragement, and you should come prepared to receive, you see? So as you receive, you know, learn from every single situation. And as you do that, that's how you leave a prophet. So as we go out there today, I want to encourage you to go out and leave a prophet. Leave a prophet. Clean things up. Well, leave a prophet. It's not looking at yourself and just thinking everybody else has to serve me or serve my goals or serve my dream. Remember, the most powerful gift someone could ever give you is their time. If someone is giving you their time, even if they're texting you or calling you or responding to you, that's the most powerful gift that they could give you. So therefore, use it wisely and therefore cherish it. When somebody texts you and checks on you, just remember there's 7.6 billion people in the world and they text you. They text you to check on you. You see, they could have texted anybody, but they text you. So that shows you how much they care. So you'll see, as you go out there, remember that. Remember that we need to leave a prophet in our relationships. We need to leave a prophet in our organizations. We need to leave a prophet in our families. And we need to leave a prophet in our friendships. And by doing that, then we build our friendships. We end up building walls. But we end up building bridges instead of walls. You see, so you want to build bridges, not building walls. So you go out there, and I want to encourage you to leave a profit. You leave a profit in someone's life today. And when somebody deposits into you, acknowledge that they're leaving something there. And when someone spends their time, even to send a note and say, how are you doing? How are you feeling today? Know that that's very important, because that person could have done anything else, but they took their time out to leave a profit in your life. So go out there and have an awesome day today. And don't forget, hit the subscribe button below. Hit the subscribe button below. When you hit the subscribe button, don't forget to select the bell, because by selecting the bell, it gives you that wonderful opportunity to be notified whenever I add a new video. God bless you and have a wonderful day.